Philippine presidential spokesperson Harry Roque failed to secure a coveted seat at the UN International Law Commission. The ILC is a body of international law experts who are tasked to develop and codify international law.
Sri Lanka 112. Herminio Harry Roque, Philippines 87.
Roque had the least number of votes among the 11 countries seeking one of the 8 seats in the ILC's Asia-Pacific region. He admits it was a challenging campaign. Meanwhile, outside the United Nations building in New York City, the rain did not stop a group of protesters from expressing their opposition to Roque's candidacy. For them, Roque's loss is a barometer of the Duterte administration's dwindling international approval.
Say it loud, say it clear!
Roque is not welcome here!
What happened today is that is a big victory for the Filipino people. It's a big embarrassment, not only for Roque, but for the Duterte regime that has consistently not only abused the Filipino people and violated our human rights, especially of our kababayan back home, but also violated international law multiple times.
Protesters also point out, even human rights lawyers oppose Roque's ILC candidacy. The Malacanang spokesman himself was a human rights lawyer prior to becoming the palace mouthpiece.
Hundreds of lawyers and other legal professionals have spoken out against this nomination and have said that Harry Roque, while technically he is a lawyer, he is unfit to be part of the International Law Commission, especially with their mandate of developing international law.
Protesters also believe their protest action at the Aretsky's Patroon, where Roque allegedly held a lavish cocktail reception to lobby for ILC voters, was the last nail in the coffin of his election bid.
Malaki yung impact no nung protesta sa Aretsky's Patroon, no doon nalantad na doon pa lang si Harry Roque nangangampanya, nilustay niya yung pera ng taong bayan para ikampanya yung sarili niya para maloklok sa ILC.
The truth has also not been completely revealed because Harry Roque himself and the Duterte administration has also failed to disclose the receipts of that extravagant dinner. We were told on the day of that at least 100 attendees, mostly UN delegates, were going to attend. So if you multiply that with $200, that's like $20,000, equivalent to 1 million Philippine pesos. How much of that came from the Filipino people's tax dollars?
The 34 elected members of the ILC will begin their 5-year term of office in January 1st, 2023. Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, New York.